Hi everybody, a very good morning, good afternoon, good evening to all of you. Welcome to the session of Power Automate Essentials to Automate Everyday Tasks by Koenig Solutions. My name is Anshu Batra and I'll be your instructor for the 1 hour of the webinar today. And I'll take you through the different concepts of Power Automate and a lot of concepts from Power Platform. I will go ahead and share my screen next, and I will get started with my introduction first. So, yes, everyone, I am a Microsoft certified trainer and I'm working as a corporate trainer with Koenig Solutions. I'm almost a decade of experience working as a trainer and I have delivered trainings worldwide to a mixed set of audience from different domains with different expertise. I've been delivering trainings majorly on a lot of tools of courses of Power Platform and a lot of data analytical tools. So I am dedicated to making learning simplified and clear, ensuring that all the participants gain practical and valuable skills. That's a little about me, everyone. Welcome to the session again, and I will now share the agenda for the session. So today, I'll take you through what is Power Platform. So I'll give you an introductory of Power Platform. Okay. So the topic of the discussion today, which is Power Automate, it's a major component of Power Platform. All right. So we'll understand then what is Power Automate and the different types of flows we have using Power Automate. Okay. So with this, let's get started discussing on what is Power Platform. So any idea about what is Power Platform? Anybody? So if you have been using Power Automate or if you have heard about Power Platform, it's widely used and a known tool these days. You can put a one-liner definition or so on the chat. What do you understand by Power Platform? Low code, no code platform. Absolutely correct. So Power Platform is a low code or a no code platform which helps us to create a complete business solution. So we can create the powerful applications with very less code or with no code. We can create applications, we can create the workflows, we can create the chatbots, the dashboards. And the major components in order to give the business solutions are Power Apps, Power BI, Power Automate, the Copilot Studio, and Power Pages. So these five components, these are the major components, five components of Power Platform, which gives us the complete business solution. Now let me quickly go ahead and give you the one-liners on these components. So Power Apps is a rapid low-code development environment which is used for building your custom apps. So it's very easy to create an application with drag and drop or point and click method to add different components and functionalities to our application. Then we have Power BI, which is a business intelligence tool which is used to perform data analysis. So it can generate and deliver insights by analyzing the data with the help of visualizations. So you can connect to different sources, you can extract the data, clean and transform the data, and you can create the reports and dashboards on based on those data models that you connect to. So it is used for data analysis. Then we have Power Automate. Power Automate is used for automating your repetitive business task or your repetitive business processes. So I'll be taking you through the Power Automate portal. I'll be showing you a few examples for creating the automated flows. Right. So let's say, for example, I want to, every day, every day at 8 a.m., we receive the birthday message, okay? So who has birthday today in the organization? So do you think every day at 8 a.m., in a huge, such huge organization, every day would anybody be sitting there noticing everyone's birthday, the calendar, and would be sending the emails across? No, right? This is an automated example. Let's say we have an employee table in a SQL Server, let's say, okay? So all the employee data is stored in the SQL Server. Now, let's say the organization has received a lot of projects and new projects, and we have a lot of new hires in the organization. So every now and then a new employee joined the organization, we sent the introduction emails to the department where the employee belonged to, or let's suppose to the entire organization. So do you think the HR people would be sitting back there and would be sending these emails every now and then? So, right, we can automate this particular process that as soon as there's a new entry in the employee table, send the email across to the belonging department or to the organization. Let's suppose you want to have some approvals, okay? So for work from home, let's say you're setting up the infrastructure for the work from home mode of working, and you want to place some orders for the infrastructure. So let's suppose if the order is lesser than 10,000, so it gets automatically approved. But if it is greater than, the value is greater than 10,000, so it requires some higher management approval. So again, you can automate such processes. Okay, so you can do all of this using the Power Automate portal. So there are dedicated portals for every component that you see in the screen right now for Power Platform. Okay, now, next we have Copilot Studio. So we'll talk more on Power Automate portal. I'll show you the different type of flows we can create and one or two examples of how do we automate the processes. Okay, now, Copilot Studio. This is used when you want to create the powerful chatbots. So it enables anyone can create the powerful chatbot using its guided or no-code graphical interface. Okay, so without you to be need to be a developer or a data scientist, you can create a chatbot with the help of this Copilot Studio tool. Okay, the only thing which will be required for you to develop the chatbot is that you need to have an idea about what type of questions the end users would ask to the chatbot, and accordingly, you can develop the chatbot. The next we have Power Pages. So Power Pages is used for building the websites. This used to be part of Power Apps portal previously, but now Microsoft has entirely a dedicated portal for developing the websites. So wherein you can have entire control on who will be able to access what data, how your website would look like, if the data will be accessed by authenticated users or by the admins only, or by unauthenticated users as well. So you can develop the custom website, external facing websites using Power Pages. Then we have a lot of features as well. It's important to understand the features of Power Platform. So like we have Dataverse, which is a built-in database of Power Platform. Data connectors. Any idea what is data connector? Anybody? What do the data connectors do? Right, that's correct. I can see if you have the answers. That's correct. So data connectors, they facilitate the integration and the interaction of your outside data storage with the components of Power Platform. So basically, the data connector act like a bridge between the components of Power Platform and outside data storage resources. Okay, so these connectors, they enable the seamless exchange of data and the flow of information from source to destination. In Power Platform, there are about 1,000 plus data connectors, pre-built data connectors. Okay, so some of them are standard ones and some of them require some license. So they are the premium connectors and the standard connectors we have in Power Platform. Then we have one more important feature, that is AI Builder, which is used to enhance your applications or the workflows with the AI capabilities. So you can create the said AI models. So there are some pre-built AI models, and you can also create the custom ones. So you can integrate the capabilities like object detection, you want to do predictions, sentiment analysis, form processing, or let's say key phase extractions. Okay, so that's about the different features and the components we have in Power Platform. Next, we have the Power Automate. So it's a service for automating your workflows across the apps and services. It connects to the data and systems you're already using to create the data you need. It creates the workflows using the triggers, edit the flow, approve the request. So you can create the workflows, you can edit the flows, you could have these approval requests to be managed on the web or mobile. So when we create the Power Automate, there are three components of Power Automate: triggers, actions, and the connectors. Two are the very major ones, triggers and the actions, the first two. So trigger basically means create a workflows using triggers, right? So trigger means how your flow will be initiated. So let's suppose we take an example that we discussed earlier, that whenever there's a new entry in the employee table, it should send an email to the entire organization. So what will be the trigger over here? A new entry in the employee table, right? So the new entry in the employee table will be a trigger. Trigger means what is going to initiate the flow. Action means what will be the next step. So we create a flow. Okay, we create a flow. We assign a trigger in the flow. Okay. So we create a flow and we assign a trigger in the flow. So trigger means starting action. What is going to initiate the flow? And then the next steps would be your action. So next action would be what? Send an email to the entire organization. Okay. Next, there are two types of flows in Power Automate. We have cloud flows and we have desktop flows. So the cloud flows again are of three types. And then we have the desktop flows. So the cloud flows work on the cloud-based scenarios. Okay, well, in the desktop flows work on the majorly on the desktop scenario. For let's say you have some legacy application, you want to record the invoicing in the application, or let's say every day, let's take an example. So every day, let's say you send a daily status report to your higher management. So every day, probably you would be creating a template and then putting up the data over there and sending it across. So you can create a desktop flow over here that, okay, every day at 5 p.m., launch a Word file, put this particular template. Okay, then you can fill the template and send it across, right? So all the desktop related tasks could be done using the desktop flows. Let's say you have an invoicing application and vendors, let's say your clients are sending you the emails over Outlook, and as you receive the emails in the Outlook, so let's say they are sending you the invoices on the mail. So you want to extract the data from the invoice received on the mail, and then you want to save that particular data to your invoicing desktop application. So how can you do that? So over here, the integration of the cloud flows and the desktop flow would work. So the cloud flows, how would they work? So as soon as you receive the email on your Outlook with the attachment of the invoice, it will trigger the cloud flow. The cloud flow will set up some parameters that will extract the data. Probably we can also use the AI builder to extract the data. And then we can save that particular data using the desktop flows from the cloud flows and save the data in the invoicing app, your desktop application. So you can integrate your cloud flows and the desktop flows as well. Okay, cloud flows are based on the cloud scenarios, wherein the desktop flows are on the desktop most scenario. values. Okay, but again, you can integrate both of them. Now, there are different ways of creating the flows. If you want to quickly get started and practicing, get started with practicing the flows, the very first way is using the templates. Okay, so there are a lot of templates. I'll be showing you a few of the examples of the templates. So see, for example, save the Office 365 email attachments to OneDrive. So let's suppose whenever you receive an email on your 365 email account, so every time you receive an email with an attachment, it must save that particular attachment to your OneDrive. Okay, save the email attachments to the SharePoint, Power Apps button. You want to send yourself a reminder every 10 minutes. You want to send yourself a reminder of probably what is the process, what is the progress on your task. So there are a lot of templates, and directly by using the templates, you can start automating. You can start with the automation. Okay, so it's not a very difficult process or a difficult interface to understand. How do we create the automation or how can we automate the daily task? Let me quickly go ahead and bring my, anyways. So yeah, let's move forward again. So guys, this is a dedicated portal which is used for creating your automated flows. Okay, I'm already logged in over here using my credentials. Okay, when you go to make.powerautomate.com. So let me put the link on the chat box, make.powerautomate.com. So when you log in on this, okay, when you log in, when you open this particular page, this is going to ask you for your login credentials. I'm already logged in over here. Now, from this particular portal, you can create the different types of flows. This is my home page, okay, wherein you have some learning information. If you're new to this portal, you can go ahead and start learning from here. Then you have this create option. So from this create option, you can go ahead and create the different types of flows, okay? So you can create the different types of cloud flows from here, okay? And you can also create the desktop flow. But the desktop flow runs on the desktop flows are created on a dedicated software. There's a desktop Power Automate for desktop software wherein we go ahead and create the desktop flows, wherein the cloud flows could be created from this particular portal. And you can install the desktop software from this particular option. Okay. So you can start creating your flows right from here, from the portal directly, or you have you have a number of templates using which we can start creating our automated flows. So if you see over here, see you have save outlook.com email attachments to your OneDrive, attachment to the Google Drive. So if you see over here, these are the automated flows. You have instant flows, you have scheduled flows. So what is the difference between these three types of flows? I'll tell you. Instant flows are triggered manually. Okay, now let's say we have a CRM system or we have created such type of automation wherein we want to manually trigger it. So whenever I require, then the particular flow should be triggered. So at that particular time, we create the instant flows. Okay, when you have a designated event, so let's suppose the example we discussed, as soon as there's an entry in the employee table, it must send an email across the organization. So this is triggered by an event. So what is the event over here? Entry in the employee table. So when you have a designated event, then you select the automated flow option. Okay, then you create the automated flow. Scheduled flow is when you want to schedule some task, or you choose that how often it should run. So using the schedule flow, you go ahead and set up the frequency, the date and time that when it should run. Let's say it must run every Monday, or let's say every first of every month, or however. So you go ahead and set up the frequency over here. Okay, so these are different types of cloud flows. So for these flows, you have the templates under this section. I opened the learn section by mistake. So let me go back over here. So we go to the template. Okay, so see, we have templates over here. Let me quickly go ahead and open one template and show you. So see, trigger a flow when a Power BI data-driven alert is created. Send an email when a new message is added to the Microsoft Teams channel. All right. And you see there are connectors as well. So you'll see the connector. So Teams, Outlook, and 365 connector is required for this. So you need to have the access for those connectors as well in order to create your flow. Save attachment to the Google Drive, Gmail attachment to the Google Drive. So you require to have a Google Drive connector and access to the Google Drive connector and the Gmail connector, right? So you have a lot of templates that you can go ahead and browse for over here. Let me quickly go ahead and show you one quick example for this. So I'll come back and show you a template. Let me quickly go ahead and create one flow to show you an example. Let's say we go ahead and create an instant flow. So we'll go ahead and trigger this particular flow manually. Okay, so I'll quickly go ahead and log into my Outlook account. Okay, let me show you over here. Let's say I open my Outlook over here. And let's suppose in my table, so let me access the table over here, the employee table. So I have an employee table in the Dataverse, and we want okay, we want that in this particular table. Let me quickly go ahead and show you the employee table. So, do I have the employee table over here? Okay, the table is not here. Let me quickly go ahead and turn the environment. So in the employee table over here, okay, we want, as soon as there's a new entry in the table, we must receive a alert message. Okay, so as soon as there's a new entry, we must receive an alert message. Or let's say we must receive an email. Okay, so I'll go back to my Power Automate and I'll go ahead and create an automated cloud flow. Now this is going to be a designated event, right? So we'll create an automated cloud flow over here, which is triggered by a designated event. So when you create this, so we're going to create employee entity flow. Okay, we give it a name. Now you go ahead and select a trigger. So you'll see there's a lot of triggers over here. So when a file is created, when item is created or modified in the SharePoint, okay, when pull request is closed, or when a row is added or modified in Dataverse. So this is the trigger that we are expecting probably. Now, very important, one more very important thing is that you need to make sure that you are working in the same environment. So I'm not sure if you're aware of the concept of environment. If you're not, then let me quickly go ahead and give you a one-liner. Environment is basically the isolated containers to, hold your assets, hold your business assets. So it's very important that you are working in the same environment. Okay, so I'll go ahead and create an automated flow. Let me quickly go ahead and give it another name again. Okay, so we go ahead and select the trigger. This time the trigger is going to be a data verse trigger. So when a row is added or modified or deleted. Okay, so this is going to be my trigger. I'll say create. Okay, let me just switch to the old designer. Okay, so see, this is a trigger when a row is added, modified, or deleted. So you need to go ahead and select the type over here. When do you want to trigger this? When the row is added, added, or deleted, added, deleted, or modified, or so on. So I'll select this option, added. Choose the entity or choose the table name over here. I'll select my employee table. Okay, the scope you select, I'll select the scope as organization columns. So there are these options which are optional, so you can just leave them blank, or there are some advanced options as well. Okay, so when a row is added or modify a row is added over here in the employee table, so what we want to do is we want to send an email. Okay, so next is action. So remember we talked about the two components we have in Power Platform in Power Automate, triggers and action. So trigger is already been set. Now we go ahead and set the action over here. So the action is going to be that we want to send an email. Okay. So you set the trigger first and then you go ahead and choose the operation or select the action. So if this is modified, so whatever action you want to perform, let's say you want to perform some Gmail action or SharePoint action, or you want to send some notification, some email notification, so you can select your required action. For now, I want to send an email to myself. Okay, so I'm using this Outlook connector. And to whom you want to send? So for the demo purpose, I'll just send it to myself. Okay. Subject. Now you can also go ahead and add dynamic content. So let's say you want to give the employee name that welcome on board, and you want to provide the employee name. So you can also go ahead and add the dynamic content from here. Or if you want to make this static, so you can also go ahead and say welcome on board employee or whatsoever. So you can also go ahead and add the dynamic content over here. So you want to add employee name or employee ID. Okay, and then let the body be, hello, we have new hire in organization, welcome thanks. Okay, all right, so we now go ahead save this. In order to see how this works, we need to create a new entry in the Dataverse table. So let's test this, and now we'll see how does this work. So we'll test this. Okay, so now we got to make a new entry in the Dataverse table. So let's say I go ahead and say a name, Rina, add a location, US, add a salary number, okay, and the performance, whatever. Okay, and the data is now saved. Okay, we'll go back over here in the flow. We'll monitor this. We do have the entry over here. And see, we have received an email over here. Welcome on board, Rina. And this is something we, right now, we configured. Right? So this is how we can go ahead and automate the flows using the Power Automate portal. Now you can see that, okay, both the steps are completed successfully and the flow ran successfully. Right? So you can create the flow right from the scratch, from this create option. Okay, you can create different types of flows, or you can also use the templates from this particular option. Okay. Now, if you want the flow to, you know, not every time you want, you know, you probably want to turn off the flow. So you can go to this menu option and you can turn it off as well from here. So let's say you don't want to receive the notifications again whenever there's a new entry. So you can turn off the flow as well. All right. So yes, this is how you can go ahead and create your automated flows, everybody. So this is not it, everyone. There are a lot of concepts we have in Power Automate. You know, there's a dedicated course for this called as PL500. Let me take you through that, okay? So I will quickly go to the portal. So you can visit the website, Koinic Solutions. I'll share the link with you on the chat. This is the link to Koinic portal, everybody. And if you want to learn more on Power Automate, okay, you can search for Power Automate over here. So we deliver 5,000 plus courses. Okay, we are partnered with Microsoft, Cisco, AWS. Okay, we are partnered with a lot of companies. Okay, and we deliver Microsoft trainings across. We have a lot of Microsoft trainers in the organization. And whatever course you are interested in, you can visit the website, search for the course. Let's say you want to learn for Power Automate. Okay, this will give you all the courses related to Power Automate. So the dedicated course and the standard course we have with Power Automate is PL500. Okay, this is a Microsoft Power Automate RPA developer course wherein you learn PL500, you learn about Power Automate end-to-end. Right from the basic, if you are not aware of how does the automation work, what is Power Platform, how do we start with the cloud flows, how do we download the Power Desktop, Power Automate Desktop software, how do we work with it, how do we register the machine. So you'll go ahead and learn about it end-to-end in this particular training session. So you can download the course content from this option and you can learn about PL500 from here. You can send us an inquiry on this particular email address. So let me share this link as well with you for PL500. Okay, you can explore the course content from here. Okay, you can send us an inquiry on this but mentioned email address and the experts will connect with you. They'll understand your training and your learning requirements. And they'll suggest the best course according to your requirement. Right? So yes, that is it from my end, everybody, for today, for the session on Power Automate Essentials. There are a lot of concepts that could not be covered in an hour. That was just an introductory on the introduction on Power Automate and the flows we create using Power Automate, right? So thank you so much for attending the session, everybody. I hope you gained a lot of knowledge out of it.